Hi, my name is Olivier Bloch. I'm a PM in the Azure Light Edge team, and I wanted to share with you a series of short videos we put together to illustrate how Microsoft can help you in your industrial IoT project. This 12-part series breaks out everything you need to know about industrial IoT at Microsoft. We start with setting up the stage, explaining a fictitious scenario with a fictitious company called Parnell Aerospace, and we show how they can leverage Microsoft technologies to go through their digital transformation. I hope you enjoy the series. Let's get started now. This is the first part of our mini series about industrial IoT. In this one, we will talk about the main issues that customers are facing in that realm and what are the key business outcomes they're looking into. For that, we're using a fictitious customer called Parnell Aerospace. Let's look at what they want to do. Manufacturers are pressured to innovate and digitally transform in order to keep up with the rapid pace of their markets. Competition, supply chain resources, worker shortage, and productivity requirements. However, digital transformation, and IoT for that matter, in manufacturing require companies to fundamentally change their business models and operations, modernize processes, highlight processes, assets, and worker inefficiencies, and give managers and frontline workers alike the tools they need to be more productive. I want to show you how Microsoft's industrial IoT platform can help manufacturers transition into this new era of the digital. I want to frame the demo that will follow by discussing the main and common challenges we see customers facing, to then describe our vision for a Microsoft cloud for manufacturing, introduce a customer scenario with specific expected business outcomes, the technical approach, and show how, with some demonstration, the value of the Microsoft Cloud for Manufacturing can be put into action. But many customers we work with share similar technical challenges when digitally transforming their businesses. Assets connectivity and management at scale is top of mind. They have existing infrastructures that we call brownfield that they need to get connected. They need to have these assets connected alongside the new ones that have been added recently. They also are implementing layered networks that ensure security across the IT and OT world. And we need to provide tools that allow them to traverse the different layers of these networks. They need to have a unified control plane as well. That's something that they already have an IT infrastructure to manage servers and PCs. And they want to have something that allows them to control these new set of assets, which are the industrial ones, that are newly connected in the same way. Security is paramount. How do you monitor and make sure that the OT infrastructure is not putting all the IT infrastructure at risk? Assets lifecycle management is something that is critical as well for them. A second aspect that is challenging in the manufacturing world is that new world where OT and IT are merging or getting together. They need to synergize IoT insights with incumbent IT and OT data. The data are available in silos, and you need to reconcile them and implement rich analytics on that. Workflows and processes need to be automated to keep up with the pace of the market. Supply chains, as we're seeing these days, are not that resilient. They need to have a new view, a new visibility into chip supply chains, and new access to data from their vendors, from their customers, to their customers as well, to ensure that these supply chains are more resilient. Last but not least, frontline workforce, which is the core of everyone's business, needs to be empowered through operations modernization. We need to be able to digitally model, visualize, analyze, explore, simulate, and predict assets and processes to drive analytics insights delivered to the workforce at all levels, whether we're talking about operators or plant managers or business people. Through our experiences with thousands of manufacturing customers' engagements, we've depicted here a fictitious amalgam of attributes from real-world customers in order to optimize the flow of this demonstration to the most typical scenario. So here we're talking about Parnell Aerospace that produces parts for the aerospace industry with factories across the US and customers across the world. They are facing the typical business scale growing pains as their market opportunity expands, which is good for them. And they need to meet that challenge by modernizing existing plants, brownfield, while paving the runway for current year and future expanded operations globally. After auditing their operations, they determined the following top priorities: implement a better and faster way to resolve product quality issues as customers regularly report product defects, and the actual manual way of resolving these issues cannot support the business growth. They need to improve workflows and processes across OT and IT, reconciling data from the two worlds. They need to solve for expertise shortage in equipment maintenance technicians. The tribal knowledge has been established around CNC machines maintenance and servicing is not something that can withstand the growth, and they need to be able to train new personnel on these equipments. All of that needs to be pursued while establishing and attaining new sustainability goals, improving their energy consumption, reducing the toxic waste generated by the production of corrosion-resistant parts. For this, they decided to modernize and digitalize their factory, integrate their IT and OT infrastructures to streamline processes and workflows, and empower their workforce implementing remote monitoring, service, and diagnostics with IoT connectivity. The following key outcomes they'll be pursuing are the following: operational and assets visibility, product quality and customer service, production operations and maintenance, automation safety and sustainability. And we'll look at each of these business outcomes and how they can achieve what they want with the Microsoft IoT platform. And Portland Aerospace, they have evaluated various solutions and decided to follow the Microsoft Cloud for Manufacturing recommendation and use Microsoft's array of packaged business capabilities to meet their needs at scale. So while helping them modernize and manage new and existing applications across the globe.